In this video, we introduce RoboGrammar, a graph grammar for terrain-optimized robot design. The goal of this framework is to generate terrain-optimized robots. To achieve this, the user specifies the range of input components which can be used to generate the robots. The task is specified through an input terrain. We then use a recursive graph grammar to generate a diverse range of different structures of robots. Using a graph heuristic search and model predictive control, we can then optimize the robot structure and controllers. First, we're going to demonstrate some of the diverse structures that the graph grammar can generate. Here, we see an example of a non-optimized robot that uses a variety of different joint types and link lengths. The user can also expand the design components to include wheels, for example, and this allows the grammar to search a different design space. Next, we consider optimized robots, and the optimization is achieved by utilizing a graph heuristic search and model predictive control. And we present the optimized robots for 6 different terrains. The first terrain we consider is flat, featureless terrain. Here we see the first example of an optimized robot. The flat terrain leads to many different robot structures and controllers. For example, the second optimized structure shows a significantly different form. The next terrain is gapped, where we have uneven terrain with gaps to encourage crossing. Here, the optimized robot uses a rigid body to help cross the gaps. Another terrain we consider is ridge terrain to encourage clambering and climbing. The optimized robot uses its articulated legs to climb over the ridges. Upward step terrain is often considered challenging for robots. The optimized robot uses its arms to pull itself up the steps. The next surface is a frozen lake, so a flat surface with a low friction coefficient. The icy terrain encourages designs that maximize traction and also utilize the low friction surface, such as this design that drags along its tail. Another optimal solution uses multiple legs to cross the low friction surface. The final terrain is a walled terrain, where high walls fall a slalom. The optimized robot has a body structure that allows for rapid changes in direction, such that it can navigate the slalom. In addition to optimizing for a single terrain, we can also perform multi-terrain optimization by finding the Pareto optimal solutions for multiple terrains. Here, we see a Pareto optimal design for ridged and walled terrain. Thank you for listening.